Hi, this is Rob. I'm going to demonstrate the Framelapse Pro app. Framelapse is an app that records time-lapse videos. It is for Android only and currently costs $2.99. There is a free version of the app. Pro version has some custom features, white balance lock, exposure lock, and a sleep mode that turns off the screen while recording in order to save battery life. We will look at all these features in this review. I am using the Framelapse Pro on a Nexus 4 phone. Let's take a look at the app. To access the features, they are located here on the left and here on the lower right. In the upper right, it displays what you currently have your settings. This blue button is the record button. It turns red once you start recording. Now let's take a look at the features. You can play or delete the most recent video. If you tap the trash can next to the recent video, it will confirm if you want to delete the recent video. Or you can go to the video gallery. Video gallery is the general video gallery of your device. You can access the Framelapse videos there. The actual location on your device where the Framelapse videos are stored are in the DCIM folder under Framelapse. DCIM stands for Digital Camera Images. Framelapse does not store the actual images that make up the time-lapse. Only the compressed time-lapse videos are stored there. If you tap the trash can next to the video gallery, you have the choice to delete all Framelapse videos or select which videos to delete. But be careful. Once you tap one of the videos, it will delete it without a warning to confirm if you want to delete this video. I have not tested the delete all button because I'm not sure if a warning window will pop up or not. This video camera icon is to set the video resolution. You can record in 1080p, 720p, and standard definition at 480p. The highest and lowest setting is the highest and lowest that your device will record. I usually use the highest setting when I use Framelapse Pro. In the bottom right is a rotation button. You can set the recording to landscape, which is the default, portrait, reverse landscape, or reverse portrait. Reverse landscape is when you turn the device upside down. This is normal landscape when the camera lens of your device is on top. Turn your device so your camera lens is on the bottom is reverse landscape. The same thing for portrait. Camera lens on top and reverse portrait, camera lens on bottom. This icon is the frame interval icon. Frame interval is how often your device takes a photo and then renders it into a time-lapse video. I usually use 1 second, which means Framelapse will take a photo every second. You have a wide variety of presets to choose from. This user-defined on the bottom is a custom frame interval that you can set here by tapping the custom button. This feature is only available on the Pro version of the app. Here you can make custom frame interval, hours, minutes, and seconds. This icon is the video duration icon. You can set how long you want the time-lapse video to be. You have a wide variety of presets to choose from. I usually use 30 seconds. This user-defined on the bottom is a custom video duration that you can set here by tapping the custom button. This feature is only available on the Pro version of the app. Here is where you make the custom video duration, hours, minutes, and seconds. This camera icon allows you to adjust several different camera settings. This icon is the self-timer. The self-timer is used to start recording at the time you set after the record button is pressed. This is so you don't get camera shake in your video when you touch the record button. I always use this feature and usually use a 10-second timer. You can also set a custom self-timer. This is the autofocus settings. This will set the focus mode. The choices you have are auto, infinity, normal, macro, and continuous video. I believe that continuous video focus is best used when you are moving your Android device as you record. I usually use infinity focus. White balance. You can set a white balance to auto, incandescent, fluorescent, daylight, and cloudy daylight. I usually use auto. White balance lock and exposure lock. You can lock in the white balance and the exposure. If these are set to on, then as soon as you start recording, it will lock in the white balance and exposure from the first frames of the recording. I usually have both of these on. FX is different filter effects that you can apply to your video as you record the video. I will come back to this in a minute and show sample video of the different effects. This is exposure compensation. These are all the choices you have for exposure compensation. The wizard button. This feature is only on the Pro version of the app. With the wizard, you choose the recording duration and the video duration, and the app will determine the frame interval. I never use the wizard. Okay, getting back to the filter effects. There are 9 different filter effects that can be applied as you are recording. These are applied as you are recording, not after you have finished recording. The effects are mono, which is black and white, negative, solarize, sepia, posterize, aqua, emboss, sketch, and neon. Here are some video examples from each of the effects. Mono, which is black and white, negative, solarize, sepia, posterize, aqua, emboss, sketch, and neon. This button on the lower right is the settings button. You can turn on a sleep mode which turns off the screen after 1 minute, but continues to record your video. This is helpful for saving the battery life of your device. I use this feature all the time. It is only available in the Pro version. You can turn on or off the shutter sound. I usually leave mine off. Switch camera. Switch from the front camera to the back camera. Community. I guess there's a Framelapse community on Facebook and Google+, but I don't use this feature. Within the help is a guide and a frequently asked questions section. Okay, that's Framelapse Pro. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel.